I love the book. It's changed my life. I have given it to my employees, but you know, I have a little bit of downtime, a little bit of a lull going on right now, and I started back 2 days ago. So what happens when you just don't feel like getting up?
Yeah.
And it's kind of tough because after meeting you, I'm like, okay, well, maybe that just doesn't happen. Just because yeah, we're so positive. Right. But surely, I mean, what happens when you just have an off day? How do you get back started?
So a few things. First and foremost, I almost never want to get out of bed. You know, it's just that there's this element. I learned it from my mentor when I was 19, do the right thing, not the easy thing. And that's in the back of my head every morning. And I think that's one of the big side benefits of the Miracle Morning is that it's how you start your day sets the tone for the type of day you create, which sets the tone for the type of life you're going to live forever. And if you start the day by hitting the snooze button, you're starting the day with procrastination. And you're literally, consider this, everybody, you're sending a message to the universe and to your subconscious that says, I would rather lie here unconscious than live my life fully and create this life that I claim that I want. But successful people know better, right? They wake up early and they dedicate time. The essence of the Miracle Morning is this. It's dedicating time every day to becoming the person that you need to be that can easily create everything you want for your life. In other words, most people wake up and they try to do more. This is about how do you become more? Because when you become more, you can actually do less and get more. So that's what this is about. It's becoming more, the every day becoming a better version of who you were when the alarm clock went off. And that's what the Miracle Morning is.
I actually have a question for you.
Yeah.
You know, if anybody's on my Facebook page, they know that I've got two little ones, a two-year-old and a three-year-old. So like Andy here, I have absolutely no problem at all waking up at 5:30. I'm not really in a good mood necessarily when it happens. But how can I incorporate something that's more positive than, you know, obviously interacting with the kids is fun, but how can I start planning my day at that time, or do I need to get up at 4:30?
I mean, so I get up at 3:30 seven days a week. Yeah. Okay. And just to be clear, that's not what the Miracle Morning is in terms of it's getting up 30 to 60 minutes before you have to, right? That's the idea is most people get up because they have to. They set their alarm when they have to get out of bed to not get fired from their job, right?
Like, gotcha.
I call that a mediocre morning, right? So, but I have a 5-year-old and a 2-year-old as well, right?
Okay.
So, So it's essentially if you have to get up to take care of the kids at 5:30, then yeah, it is getting up at 5 or at 4:30 and dedicating that time. And it's like anything. What's you go to bed at 30 minutes earlier to get up 30 minutes earlier. You go to bed an hour earlier to get up an hour earlier. Right.
How many hours a night do you sleep?
Six. And I talked about that in the book that there's so many different studies and there's so many people in history, some of the greatest minds in history that have contributed to our society from Albert Einstein, Thomas Edison, that they were known for sleeping 4 or 5 hours a night. And I don't advocate sleep deprivation or anything, but I my belief is this, the mind-body connection is a powerful thing. And so we need, in my opinion, how much sleep we believe we need largely influences how we feel when we wake up in the morning. If you think you need 8 hours, you go, I need 8 hours. I'm only getting six tonight. I'm screwed. I'm going to be exhausted in the morning. Alarm clock goes off. Your first thought is the last thought you had before bed, which is, oh my God, it's morning. I only slept 6 hours. I'm exhausted. So I experimented with, hey, what if I tell myself that I'm going to feel amazing off 6 hours, right? And I create that intention. And every time I felt the way I decided I was going to feel before I went to bed.